this week's episode, we visited Yiayia Betty to show us how to cook an amazing Greek recipe.
Yiayia, show me how to cook!
Two contestants joined us on the show.
I had lots of salt, like my AI used to teach me what to do.
Then have a cook-off in the kitchen.
Are you guys ready?
Oh yeah.
Absolutely, bring it on.
Yiayia Betty then tastes both dishes, and the most successful contestant is crowned the champion cook of the week.
May the best chef win.
Yiayia's cooking is always the best in Greek and Cypriot families, but let's go and find out for ourselves how these traditional recipes are achieved. We are going to meet Yiayia Betty, a Yiayia from Greece. We find out what sofrito is and how to cook it. Hello. Γεια σας.
Τι κάνετε?
Καλά, εσύ?
Μια χαρά. Καλώς ήρθατε στο σπίτι μας. Θέλετε να περάσουμε μέσα?
Ευχαριστούμε.
Παρακαλώ.
Βρισκόμαστε στο σπίτι της Μπέτσης, μας φιλοξένησε και μας κέρασε και ένα ποτήρι ούζο.
Στην υγειά μας, κορίτσια.
Θα πιούμε και λίγο.
Βέβαια.
Τώρα πες μου λίγο για το εαυτό σου, από ποιο νησί της Ελλάδας είσαι?
Εγώ είμαι από την Κέρκυρα. Ένα από τα ωραιότερα νησιά ανά τον κόσμο. Βέβαια όλη η Ελλάδα μας είναι πανέμορφη, αλλά ποιος την περνάει την πατρίδα του. Έτσι κι εγώ λοιπόν λέω ότι η Κέρκυρα είναι ένα πανέμορφο νησί. Με πολύ ωραίους ανθρώπους, πολύ ωραία ήθη και έθιμα, πολύ ωραία κουλτούρα. Φιλόξενοι, είμαστε πάρα πολύ φιλόξενοι άνθρωποι. Κάθε ένας, από όποιο μέρος του κόσμου και αν επισκεφθεί την Κέρκυρα, για μία φορά δεν θα την ξεχάσει ποτέ. Όσοι μπορούν και έχουν την οικονομική ευχέρεια θα πάνε και θα ξαναπάνε. Ορισμένοι φεύγουν από τους τόπους τους και αγοράζουν ή νοικιάζουν κάτι στην Κέρκυρα και μένουν μόνιμα.
Ναι.
Είμαι λοιπόν πολύ περήφανη που γεννήθηκα και είμαι από την Κέρκυρα. Βέβαια λείπω τα τελευταία 20 χρόνια από το όμορφο νησί, αλλά πηγαίνω πάρα πολύ συχνά.
Είσαι εδώ τώρα και ναι, τα παιδιά σου είναι εδώ. Ναι. Εσύ τα έμαθες τα παιδιά σου να μαγειρεύουν όπως εσένα?
Κοίταξε να δεις, πιστεύω ότι όταν η μητέρα μέσα στο σπίτι ασχολείται με κάτι και τα παιδιά τη βλέπουν, δεν μπορεί, όσο και να μην αρέσει, κάτι θα πάρουν. Ναι, λοιπόν, ο πρώτος μου ο γιος το έκανε και επάγγελμα, είναι σεφ. Αυτή τη στιγμή βρίσκεται στην Ελλάδα, ελπίζω σύντομα να είναι πάλι μαζί μας. Ο δεύτερος όμως ο γιος μου, ο οποίος είναι και μπαμπάς, από αυτόν έχω την εγγονούλα την τριών ετών και περιμένω και το δεύτερο σε λίγους μήνες. Και αυτός όμως, όχι σαν επάγγελμα, όμως μαγειρεύει για την οικογένειά του, για το σπίτι του, φτιάχνει πολύ ωραία φαγητά. Είναι κάτι το οποίο μας αρέσει και εντάξει, αν αρέσει κάτι, γιατί να μην το...
Γιατί να μην το κάνεις.
Βεβαίως.
Αυτά τα φαγητά που μαγειρεύεις εσύ,
ναι,
από πού τα έμαθες?
Τη μητέρα.
Τη μητέρα. Ήταν και αυτή η καλή στη...
Η μεγάλη μου δασκάλα. Okay.
Ναι, δασκάλα.
Είναι και θα είναι. Να είναι καλά η γυναίκα, ναι, είναι πολύ μεγάλη δασκάλα, είναι καταπληκτική μαγείρισα και μέχρι σήμερα μπορεί να κάνω κάτι και να την παίρνω τηλέφωνο, της πω μαμά, πες μου εκείνο, πες μου το άλλο, είναι πολύ καλή στη μαγειρική και από εκεί πήραμε κι εμείς.
Πώς, όταν ήσουν μικρή την έβλεπες, όταν μαγείρευε και μαθαίνες?
Βέβαια, και την βοηθούσα.
Και μετά, πότε
άρχισε? Και την βοηθούσα, όταν παντρεύτηκα.
Α, μετά.
Ναι, με τη βοηθούσα, ναι. Φέρε μου αυτό, φέρε μου το άλλο, έβλεπα, αλλά όταν παντρεύτηκα πλέον, είχα όλα αυτά συγκεντρωμένα, ξέρεις, τις γνώσεις, ναι, τις γνωρίζεις. Μετά το έκανα και σε πράξη και βγήκα πολύ καλή μαγειρίσα, διότι μου αρέσει αυτό που κάνω.
Ναι, ναι. Και πες μου, να αλλάξουμε θέμα τώρα, ναι, πες μου τι δουλειά κάνεις.
Η δουλειά μου δεν έχει καμία σχέση, ναι, με αυτό εδώ το που κάνουμε σήμερα. Αλλά εντάξει, μπορεί να αλλάζει το είδος. Η καλλιτεχνία όμως, όταν την έχεις μέσα σου, συνεχίζεται και σε άλλα είδη. Έτσι λοιπόν να σου πω ότι εδώ και πάρα πολλά χρόνια ασχολούμαι με το marketing, ξεκινώντας από όταν τελείωσα το κολέγιο. Από εκεί και πέρα ασχολήθηκα με το marketing. Πρώτα στην Κέρκυρα, μεταγενέστερα στην Αθήνα, όπου κατέληξα να κάνω μόνη μου εισαγωγές από χώρες της Ανατολής. Και έφερνα αντίκες Είτε αυτό ήταν έπιπλο, είτε ήταν χειροποίητο χαλί, είτε κόσμημα, είτε πορσελάνες, όπως ο λιμόζο, έπιπλα σε Louis XV, Louis Vuitton, κομμάτια καταπληκτικά.
Ναι, ναι, ναι.
Τα οποία τότε, πριν κάποια χρόνια, τα διέθετα στην αγορά μέσω live auction στην τηλεόραση.
Α,
ναι, βέβαια.
Ίσως στην τηλεόραση.
Για 10 ολόκληρα χρόνια έκανα αυτή τη δουλειά.
Σε ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ και μετά θα πάμε να μαγειρέψουμε το σοφρίτο, το φαγητό από την Κέρκυρα. So we've learned all about our Yiayia Betty, but now let's go and find out a little bit more about our two contestants.
That looks tasty. Hi, my name's Andrew Jacovides. I'm a children's television producer, and you just caught me looking through a few recipes here, trying to read up on what Yiayia might be throwing at us. Hopefully it's not a salad. My hobbies include video games and music and film. I really enjoy all of those. I especially enjoy cooking. It's one of my passions, but I do end up ruling the roost when I'm in the kitchen, so my contestant needs to watch out for that. I'm really looking forward to coming on the show and seeing what Greek recipes Yiayia has for us. It should be a really great time, so bring it on.
Hi, my name's Christina. I'm the writer and PR manager of Digital Mosaic, a design agency. I also have my own fashion blog, Stylish Wish. When I heard about Yiayia showing me how to cook, I thought it was such a good idea because it's important to pass down traditional recipes. And my inspiration was my Yiayia Maria on my mum's side. She was the best cook I've ever known. And everyone used to always help themselves to seconds when we used to go and visit her nearly every weekend because the food was that good. So if I get to be half as good a cook as my Yiayia was, then I'll be happy. I don't get the time to cook as often as I would like to. But when I do get the chance, I like to make the effort. So I am looking forward to the challenge of expanding my culinary horizons. That said, let the rivalry begin and may the best chef win.
Today's dish is a speciality all the way from the beautiful Greek island of Corfu, also known as Kerkyra. Now this is where Yiayia here is from. And what are we cooking today? Τι θα μαγειρέψουμε?
Σήμερα θα μαγειρέψουμε ένα παραδοσιακό κορφιάτικο φαγητό το οποίο ονομάζεται σοφρίτο.
Σοφρίτο?
Ναι.
Do you know what sofrito is?
Ah, sofrito!
Yeah?
No idea.
No. Okay, we're going to find out very, very shortly. But now that we're all here,
Yiayia, show me how to cook!
Πάμε λοιπόν.
Let's go! For this week's dish of sofrito, serving 5 to 6 people, you need 5 to 6 pieces of thinly sliced lean beef, one whole garlic diced, one bunch of parsley finely chopped, one glass of red wine, salt and pepper, plain flour, and olive oil. Cook time is approximately 1 hour and 45 minutes.
Sofrito is one of Kerkyra's native specialities. It's a fried beef with a wine sauce. It's usually served with chips or rice. But yeah, you're our teacher. Πες μας, πώς κάνουμε το σοφρίτο?
Ναι, βεβαίως. Λοιπόν, να παρουσιάσουμε πρώτα και να πούμε ότι για να γίνει αυτό το φαγητό χρειαζόμαστε κρέας, μοσχάρι, αλεύρι, μαϊντανό, σκόρδο, αλάτι, πιπέρι, απαραίτητο συστατικό είναι το κόκκινο κρασί και λαδάκι. Να ξεκινήσουμε όμως την προεργασία για να φτιάξουμε το ωραίο φαγητό μας, το σοφρίτο. Πάμε λοιπόν, παίρνοντας το κομματάκι από το κρέας, το αλευρώνουμε.
So she's putting the beef in the alevrin. She's covering it.
Πρώτα όμως θα πρέπει να βάλουμε το λαδάκι μας. Ένα ποτήρι λάδι μας είναι αρκετό. Θα περιμένουμε λιγάκι.
Και πόση ώρα πρέπει να είναι εκεί? It's lightly fried, δεν είναι...
Μόλις ξεκινήσει και βράσει το λάδι μας, θα το κάνουμε μία από τη μία, μία από την άλλη, ένα ελαφρό τηγάνισμα. Και αμέσως κομμάτι-κομμάτι που θα τηγανίζεται, θα το τοποθετούμε μέσα στην κατσαρόλα. Να προσθέσουμε και το πιπεράκι μας. Πιπέρι βέβαια και αλάτι, να σας πω ότι είναι στον καθέναν που θα το μαγειρέψει πόσο ακριβώς θέλει.
So it's up to you guys how hot like you want it with the pepper. Yeah. Of course, the salt, how salty you want it.
Yeah. Okay, ήδη λοιπόν το λαδάκι μας έχει αρχίσει
και ζεσταίνεται. Mm-hmm. Γυρίζουμε από την άλλη μεριά το κρέας μας. Δεν θέλουμε να τηγανιστεί τελείως, απλά το σοτάρουμε.
Ναι. Η κέρκυρα, it was taken over by the Venetians.
Ναι, βεβαίως. Ήμασταν κάτω από την ενετική αρχή για 400 χρόνια, βέβαια.
Και αυτό το
όλα τα επτάνησα, όλα τα επτάνησα. Ναι, είναι ιταλικής προέλευσης, όπως έχουμε και άλλα και πολλά άλλα είδη φαγητών, τα οποία δεν υπάρχουν στην άλλη Ελλάδα.
Ναι.
Όπως έχουμε την παστιτσάδα.
Ναι.
Είναι και αυτό δικιά μας. Ναι, ναι, βέβαια. Και πολλά άλλα φαγητά, βέβαια.
Το όνομα είναι ιταλικό, Σοφρίτο.
Βέβαια. Έχουμε πολύ μεγάλη επιρροή στην κουζίνα μας από τους Ιταλούς, τους γειτονές μας. Λοιπόν.
Αυτό είναι έτοιμο τώρα.
Ναι, είναι έτοιμο, όχι για φαγητό. Είναι έτοιμο για να το βάλουμε στην κατσαρόλα μας μέσα. Είναι η προεργασία, μέχρι να γίνει η προεργασία του σοφρίτου. Μόλις τελειώσω και αυτό, μπορείτε να με ρωτήσετε και αν έχουν τα παιδιά κάποια απορία, να με ρωτήσουν. Είναι ένα από τα αγαπημένα μου φαγητά που μαγειρεύουμε μαζί, βέβαια, με ό,τι άλλες κερκυραϊκές συνταγές έχει η παράδοσή μας. Είμαι πιστή στην κερκυραϊκή παράδοση, όμως και στην ελληνική παράδοση.
Βλέπω ότι σου άρεσε πάρα πολύ στην κουζίνα και να μαγειρεύεις.
Είναι ένα από τα αγαπημένα μου χόμπι, όχι μόνο για φαγητά και γλυκά ακόμα. Το έμαθα από τη μητέρα μου αυτό. Γεννήθηκα σε ένα σπίτι όπου η κουζίνα έπαιζε πρωταρχικό ρόλο στην οικογένειά μας. Υπήρχε και υπάρχει μια μητέρα με πολύ μεγάλη πείρα και γνώσεις πάνω στη μαγειρική και στη ζαχαροπλαστική, οπότε θέλοντας και μη, έμαθα και εγώ φυσικά. Λοιπόν, έτσι συνεχίζουμε και στα σπίτια μας, βέβαια.
Και μας μαθαίνεις εμάς τους.
Βεβαίως, βεβαίως.
How's it looking, guys?
Tasty.
Yeah, it smells good actually.
Yeah,
it does. Yeah. You can really smell the fried beef.
Later on.
Smells better, even better than
ever. Ναι, καλύτερα θα μυρίζει. Αργότερα θα μυρίζει καλύτερα. Το σκόρδο, το μαϊντανό και η αναθυμίαση από το κρασί θα κάνουν έναν υπέροχο συνδυασμό. Λοιπόν, ήρθε η σειρά να ρίξουμε το σκορδαράκι μας μέσα στο λάδι το οποίο ήδη σιγοβράζει από όταν τηγανίσαμε το κρέας μας. Ρίχνουμε αρκετό μαϊντανό. Μπορώ να πω ένα ματσάκι ολόκληρο και ένα ολόκληρο σκόρδο.
Wow. One whole garlic.
Ναι, είναι αυτή η επιτυχία και ρίχνουμε
μαϊντανό
και το κρασάκι μέσα.
Εγώ νόμιζα ότι ήθελα να το
πιούμε μετά, με το τελείωμα. Όταν το δοκιμάσουμε θα έχουμε και ένα ποτήρι κρασάκι να πίνουμε μαζί. Λοιπόν, αφήνουμε λιγάκι να βράσουν. Απλά έτσι να κοχλάσει λίγο.
Ναι.
Θα έχουμε ένα καταπληκτικό αποτέλεσμα. Όταν να ολοκληρωθεί το φαγητό μας, να πω ότι το σερβίρουμε με πουρέ ή με πατάτες τηγανιτές ή με πιλάφι.
Τι προτιμάς εσύ να το...
Εγώ προσωπικά το πουρέ.
Το πουρέ.
Εμένα ναι, προσωπικά μου αρέσει πάρα πολύ το πουρέ. Λοιπόν, ήρθε η ώρα. Εντάξει.
Πώς ξέρουμε ότι είναι έτοιμο τώρα?
Δύο-τρία, δεν είναι έτοιμο αυτό. Ναι. Απλά έχει γίνει μία μίξη των υλικών που έβαλα μέσα.
Ναι.
Οι μυρωδιές τους θα μυρίζεις και τώρα είναι υπέροχες.
Ναι.
Σκόρδο μαϊντανό, το λαδάκι, το κρασάκι κάνει μία πολύ ωραία σύνθεση. Αυτή λοιπόν τη σάλτσα που δεν έχει τελειώσει, απλά είναι μία προεργασία, θα τη ρίξουμε. Να μεταφέρω την κατσαρόλα μας εδώ. Τη ρίχνω λοιπόν, το βλέπουμε, εδώ. Πολύ ωραία. Ρίχνουμε και το νεράκι. Γύρω στα 3 με 4 ποτήρια νερό.
And that's exactly, you know exactly how much.
Ναι, έχω πάρει πλέον, ναι. 3 με 4 ποτήρια νερό, σκεπάζουμε την κατσαρόλα μας και αφήνουμε γύρω στη μία μισή ώρα χρόνο για να τελειοποιηθεί το φαγητό μας. Βέβαια, αναταχτά χρονικά διαστήματα κοιτάζουμε, διότι μπορεί να χρειαστεί λίγο νεράκι ακόμα, μην μας πιάσει, και σε σιγανή φωτιά.
Okay.
Ελπίζω λοιπόν σε λίγο να φάμε και να δοκιμάσουμε.
Yes, I'm certainly very hungry. To explain to you guys, Yaya's put 3 to 4 glasses of water in there and she's left it for an hour and 15 minutes?
Yes.
Yeah, something like that. And you keep checking it. If it needs more water, you add some more. That's it. You just leave it there and it cooks. Yeah?
Okay.
And then at the end, you have a delicious meal and with a glass of wine.
Lovely. Πιστεύω ότι θα έχετε τέλειο αποτέλεσμα.
So that's it, we leave it for an hour and 15 minutes and I don't know what we're going to do now, we're going to have to wait and have some tea, coffee, yeah?
Γιατί όχι, βεβαίως.
Wine?
Ένα τσαγάκι.
Okay.
Γιατί όχι, και ένα κρασάκι, βεβαίως.
Okay, we'll be right back. The sofrito is now ready, so I'm not going to wait around, I'm going to dig in because it looks absolutely delicious. Let me cut a little bit of here.
Oh, fantastic.
Very good. Really, really good. Wow. You can really taste all the flavour, every single flavour you put in there.
Exactly.
You can really, really taste it. I'm going to carry on eating. Guys, think of some questions to ask Yaya maybe, because this is your final chance now.
Sure. When you're cooking, what kind of heat are you putting that on? Is it low to medium or medium to high? Does it vary from different parts of the recipe?
The first part, low.
Right.
The second one, medium.
Okay.
The second step,
sure.
Medium.
And what kind of beef do you use?
You know, it depends what did you like. You can, μπορείς να χρησιμοποιήσεις νουά, φιλέτο, οποιοδήποτε μέρος από το beef μπορείς να το χρησιμοποιήσεις, μόνο να μην έχει πάχος.
Okay.
Και λεπτές, να είναι κομμένο σε λεπτές φετούλες, για να μπορεί να ψηθεί γρήγορα.
Understood.
Okay.
All right, guys, you happy? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, go for it.
I'm going to put these down because I don't trust myself. So thank you very, very much for your version of sofrito. Let's hope Christina and Andrew can give such a good version of it too. But we will be back after the break with Andrew and Christina, who will be having a big cook-off and probably going to have a lot of beef in the kitchen, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, very much. Good luck.
Thanks.
Welcome back to part two of Yaya Show Me How to Cook, where Andrew and Christina have accepted the challenge to replicate Yaya Betty's sofrito. But the question is, who will win the battle of cooking cattle? I really got to stop saying these bad beef jokes. So on with the show. The next part of the show, we will witness the big cook-off, and our two contestants will cook to the best of their ability to impress Yaya Betty with their sofrito. Are you guys ready?
Oh yeah,
absolutely. Bring it on.
Yep. Bring it on.
Absolutely.
Right. So I guess I better give you your aprons. Here you go.
Very much.
Here you go.
Okay. Thank you.
Right. So whenever you're ready, guys, you can start cooking. How are you feeling?
I'm pretty confident because blue's my lucky colour.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
How's that?
Because it's just my favourite colour, and I support Spurs.
Oh, I see, okay. And
Leighton Owen, who are red, so I'm happy in red at
so
the moment,
fine,
so we're good.
Fine. Right, guys, off you go, and good luck.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Oh no, mine's not pouring out.
Try opening it, maybe. That's the one.
Make sure.
Disaster
actually,
already.
I'm just going to take the whole thing off.
Do you guys remember what you're doing?
Yep.
I think she's got the idea there of
unscrewing
the whole thing. Now the
there
trick.
We go.
There you go. Right. So I'm sensing that you're quite good in the kitchen.
Oh, thanks.
Good cooking experience, maybe.
Either that, or I'm a really adept knife thrower. You know.
Are you?
No, not really.
So do you cook much at home, Christina?
I don't often find the time to as much as I would like, mm-hmm. but when I do, I remember when I was younger, I used to pretend, you know, like when you watch the cookery shows and then you say, oh, here's one I made earlier.
Yes.
I don't know why I always say it in that accent though either. It's just
a Blue Peter thing, I guess.
Yeah.
So you used to pretend that you were a chef on TV and now your dreams have come true.
Yeah,
in a way.
So thanks for that.
So, Christina, what do you do then?
Well, I work for a digital design agency where I do all the writing for their news feeds, their blogs, and the copywriting for other websites.
Right, okay.
And I also do their PR and marketing. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
You enjoy that?
Yeah, it's really good. Creative, so I like to do anything creative, including cooking.
Mm-hmm. And I understand, Andrew, you work in a very creative business as well.
Yes, I'm a promotions producer currently working for Kids TV.
Kids TV?
Yeah, absolutely. Mainly for cartoons. So, yeah, so I promote all new cartoons that come out and things
That.
In like 12 different languages, even though I only speak a couple, but still.
One of them Greek?
Unfortunately, one of them's not Greek, no. I am learning, because so my family always want me to learn how to speak, but yeah. My dad speaks, so I practice with him, which is quite good. But no, I really should pick that up again, you know. Try and learn.
Maybe I can show you how to cook
and speak.
Cook Sofrito and
yes.
You know, pick up a few
words.
Yeah,
show me
well.
How to speak Greek. That'd be great.
Oh dear.
Right. I'm going to take the plunge.
Take the plunge.
Start on the garlic.
Ooh. Right, I think I'll hold my nose for this part of the show.
Yeah, this will definitely keep the vampires away.
That's true. So, Christina, you cook Greek food at home?
Yeah, I try to. I have a Greek recipe book called Kopiaste.
Ah.
And it's got all the traditional Greek recipes. So I've tried a few, which have been successful apart from one.
Right. Which one was that?
Lokmades, which funnily enough actually was not in the book. I had to get the recipe from the internet, and that's where I went wrong. I should have listened to my dad, who's really good at making lokmades, but I wanted to do it all myself.
Mm-hmm.
So
what did you do? Tell me the disaster.
Well, basically, it's my boyfriend's favourite dessert, so I thought, oh, I'll make him a nice treat. And I tried to make it for him, and he came round to eat, and he was really looking forward to it. So I served it to him on a plate and gave him the fork.
Right.
And
I'm still waiting for the punchline. This one.
When he went to put the fork into the lokmades, it didn't penetrate them. They were rock hard, like stones.
Oh my goodness.
And he said, "I can't eat these, rah! I'm going to break my teeth." and also, that wasn't the only thing. The syrup was too sticky. So he turned the bowl upside down, and it was stuck
to
the bowl. It wouldn't move.
You tried to kill him.
It wasn't premeditated, but we soaked it in the sink overnight so that we could wash the dishes and the casserole dish and the saucepans. And when they the next morning, when they'd soaked, the lokmades were so bouncy, like rubber balls. They'd gone soft,
gosh.
And everyone was bouncing them up and down in the kitchen. So, yeah.
You're feeling a bit more confident now.
Yeah, I think my chances have suddenly gone up.
But since then, I have cooked other dishes that have been successful.
Okay.
Yeah.
How about you, Andrew? Do you cook Greek stuff? Or
yeah, no, I do cook Greek. I do cook Greek food as well. I'm mainly sort of chef de l'oeuvre and kefteles, and occasionally the mothers as well. If I can get the vine leaves, though, they're kind of the harder things to source. But you can usually pick them up from anywhere in North London.
Yeah, so, that's true.
So yeah, so that's.
Well, some people they grow them in their garden.
Yeah, absolutely. Leaves. But no, unfortunately, I haven't got my own vine in my garden. I really should. I'm going to cook the mothers a lot.
Mm.
But yeah. So no, I really enjoy Greek cooking. I like the, as I'm a bit of a meat eater, so I enjoy.
So you cook a lot of souvla.
Yeah. Oh yeah. I'm a mean souvla cooker, that's for sure.
Just watching it rotate.
Yeah. Well, no. Well, of course, there's the electronic way, but I prefer the more traditional way. Absolutely. You know, over a brick made fire,
oh,
and then
wow.
You kind of. Get the ridiculously long skewer and you're trying to rotate it from there. So.
I'm impressed. Right, so Christina, I hear that your hobbies are food, fashion and films.
Yes, so amongst other things.
Amongst other things, but yeah, like, you know, talk us through that.
Okay, well, I have my own fashion blog called Stylish Wish, www.stylishwish.co.uk or .com.
Right, okay.
Both of those domains work.
And you have a lot of followers on that?
Yeah, especially on Twitter.
Yeah.
I'm on Facebook as well. So
now here's the opportunity to put a name to the fashion blog,
Yeah, I also love films, so I'm at the cinema all the time, pretty much.
Food, of course.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Food, of course.
Yeah.
Yes.
Last but not least. And I like reading and writing and sports, things like that.
So yeah.
busy.
A little birdie tells me that you eat a lot of food, like all the time.
Yes.
And you know, you're always seen with something in your pocket or, you know, holding some sort of food. Where do you put it? That's my first question, because you're very slim and...
It just goes straight to my nose.
No, seriously.
No, I'm tall, so I guess I can take it. It's all in proportion to me.
And Andrew, tell us a bit more about your hobbies, what you like doing.
I like to play guitar, so I play that
musician.
Quite... Yes, I like to play, so I'm self-taught. During my A-levels, actually, I just decided to run online and bought a guitar. It arrived. My mum was furious, the fact that I wasn't revising and I was trying to learn how to play guitar. But YouTube kind of taught me kind of different things, how to play certain chords, and then you kind of sort of learn from there. So the internet's a great resource for sort of teaching yourself that. So mainly playing that and...
Do you play live anywhere? I mean...
Oh, no.
It's just a hobby.
It's literally just for myself, just to... And a way of expression, should we say. But I enjoy swimming as well. I mean, sort of, I like that to keep fit. I'm asthmatic, so that kind of is a good way to sort of help out with treating that. Apart from the video games, I'm a big video game nut. Bit sad, but I enjoy it. Bit of a geek, so pretty much.
And cooking, of course.
Yes, and cooking, of course. Yeah. No, I enjoy. I like baking as well. I like baking cakes and cookies, brownies, things like that. My girlfriend enjoys like cooking as well, so we kind of that's kind of the thing that we enjoy together.
You can show her a new dish now.
Yeah, well, absolutely. Well, I can show.
Let's say if you succeed.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, exactly. And to be another.
So, Christina, I hear your grandma's a big influence in your life. Tell me a bit more about her.
She's no longer with us, sadly, but I'm sure she's with me in spirit.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Definitely.
She's
saying to you, Christina Moore, cook some food and make me proud. Yeah. I don't know if she sounded like that, though.
Not quite, but I get the gist of it. Basically, she was a petite, very kind lady, and she was quite religious, always wanted to make sure her family was well fed,
right.
You know, and she was one of the best cooks I knew. We always looked forward to going round there every weekend and eating multiple servings of her feast that she would lay before us.
She must have worked really, really hard to every weekend really to have everybody around and cook and...
She was like the central role of the family, you know. Everyone would stick together, you know, come together rather, because they knew she was cooking.
I mean, that sounds like, you know, typical grandmas, Greek and Cypriot grandmas.
Absolutely.
You know, they want to feed everyone, they want to cook. They're little and frail and old and they're very religious. It sounds very typical. Is your grandma anything like that?
She used to be, I'd say. I was quite young when she was that active. Unfortunately, she's not. She's mostly disabled now, so she's not as active. But my auntie Sally, she's much more active and able, and she does most of the cooking. And say she kind of got me into sort of Greek cooking a lot more.
Yeah.
And so I say I always enjoy kind of Greek cuisine, and I say a bit of a meat eater, so I say I really enjoy.
What's your favourite meat?
Oh, souvla. Everyone loves souvla.
Souvla.
Everyone loves a good souvla. Never met a Greek who doesn't like a good souvla.
She's got the casserole now.
That's a lot. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
No problem. There you go.
Right, cool. Put that back on.
What are you thinking about this dish? I mean, is it
looks
something you'd cook?
It looks very tasty. I mean, from the dish. I mean, I think once I know how to cook it, I'll definitely cook it again if I cook it right. You know, have to ask Yaya for the recipe on paper, so just in case I forget it.
And that's how you turn
you don't
water
drink that.
Into wine.
So in Cartoon Network, do you sit there and watch cartoons all day?
People think I do, and unfortunately it's true, I do watch cartoons most of the day, so we have to get to know the cartoons quite well, I'd say otherwise it won't. Yeah, so otherwise we won't know.
Your
the
face dropped there.
It was good, that's how it was, it's quite a pungent red wine. I was like, there's a lot of red wine there.
it's quite a bitter taste, just because the way the garlic and the actually the parsley doesn't help with it. So it's quite a bitter taste. But say once it all reduces down, that'd be quite nice when the meat and so when the meat goes in, we casserole the whole thing.
You do watch cartoons all day then?
Unfortunately so, yes. I would like to admit that I don't, but say I really do.
Do you come up with any of the ideas for any of the cartoons?
I have some ideas sort of floating around, but I'm only a promoter. I don't necessarily do the pitching as such.
Do you like Simpsons?
Yes. Yeah, I've always liked that
kind of thing. They have good humour, don't they?
That does smell really good.
Yeah, it does.
It really does.
Right.
Alright. What are you thinking so far? Confident, Lauren? Doing well? Got the ingredients?
I'm pleased that I remembered how to do the recipe.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now it's just all about the taste, really, how it's going to turn out. So,
fingers crossed. I think Yaya's going to have a difficult decision to make. Well, I'm saying that now, but let's see if she finds it.
Absolutely.
So, I have to time it exactly.
She's got her watch out.
Right.
I think, have you finished putting all your ingredients in?
Yeah.
I'm happy for that.
You've
now
got your lid.
That'll now boil.
This reminds me of when I was a child in the garden and used to pretend and gather all the plants and pour water and pretend to make soup.
But it wasn't soup, it was like a mud gloop. I used to do that too.
Yeah.
I used to put, you know, odd bits of grass, bit of flowers, mud, water, mix it all up.
Did your parents tell you off for ruining the flowers?
They didn't know, something they do now. So now, guys, it's the waiting game. We've got to wait for a while until it all cooks up, clean up, have a little bit of a rest.
Yep, sure.
Yeah. Keep an eye on it, of course.
Yes.
So it doesn't burn. Do you remember how long we've got to leave it?
About an hour and 15.
Yeah.
It's just about that, you know, it should be about.
Yes?
Yep.
Confident?
Yeah.
Right, next part is the result, and we'll be right back to see what Yaya thinks of their cooking. Heaven help her.
I'm really happy with the way that the cooking went today. I think I did quite well. You know, I think I messed up on a few of the steps. Yeah, I might be very happy. I'll probably get a clap on the back of my head for that one. Yeah, I think I put the water in too early. And I noticed that Christina had, and I was like, oh no, I put one too in too early. But hopefully it will come out tasting well. I seasoned it enough. I had lots of salt. Like, my AI used to teach me what to do. Maybe should have added more salt. Might add more salt next time. And hopefully it'll turn out really nice. And yeah, I really like it.
I'm really happy that I learned a new recipe. Andrew was a very determined opponent, so I'm a bit concerned that he's going to try and sabotage my dish. But apart from that, I'm confident because odana mayref gasto horko to ogaros mo pienen jerken jeferen daily gamu to horko istan nado gimasun to psomi mu. Και άρεσαν τους τόσο πολλά, είπαν ότι είναι το πιο καλύτερο ψωμί στη ζωή και ήταν πόμπα, μάνα μου, πόμπα.
Well, the time is up for Andrew and Christina. They've worked really, really hard in the kitchen and this is their first attempt of sofrito. So they are here to impress Yaya with their dishes. Now, you look a little bit worried, Christina. How are you feeling?
I have to win, or it means three words. Re-zi-li.
Oh my goodness. So in English that means humiliation beyond repair,
yeah,
basically.
Utter humiliation.
And Andrew, how are you feeling?
Quietly confident, but I mean, anything could happen, so it's up to Yaya now.
Well, I want to wish you both the best of luck. And Yaya will be judging these plates on presentation and taste. So Yaya, θα μας πεις ποιο είχε την καλύτερη εμφάνιση και ποιο είχε την καλύτερη γεύση.
Το καλύτερο μαγείρεμα.
Ναι.
Ωραία. Ξεκινάμε νέα αμέσως τώρα με το πρώτο εδώ δεξιά.
So Yaya does not know whose plate is whose right now. You guys look so nervous. I feel the nerves for you.
I like.
You like
it's
it?
Tasty.
Ooh, good, good, good. Right, about this one. This one's got, is that some sort of spinach around it, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay. So they've both gone with different kinds of presentation here. Both look great, I think. Yeah?
Mm. Both the presentations, very nice.
Yes.
But the tasting is better this one.
Is this one?
Yes.
Okay, well, yes. Let's. We're going to lift the plate and yes. We're going to find out which colour it was. Okay, so here we go. And that means, Christina, you are our Hellenic Cook of the Week. Well done.
Good,
thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Congratulations. Thank
you. You can tell she's very, very happy.
Bravo.
Good game. Good game. It was good. So, congratulations. You've won yourself a dinner for two. Yeah. Dinner for two.
Thank you.
And who are you going to take?
Well, I like to eat a lot, so probably me, myself, and I. No, I'm joking. No, I'll probably take my boyfriend with me.
Ah, okay, okay. Let's hope he's very proud of you now.
I hope so.
And Andrew, how are you feeling? Runner-up?
No, it's good. I'm glad I learned the recipe today, so I can definitely try and perfect it and hopefully get the chance to impress you later on in life.
Definitely. I mean,
Andrew and yours, it's really, really nice, tasty. But,
hey, if one's better than the other, of course.
It's alright.
What was the difference? Yeah, yeah. Why was
it's
this
more,
one?
It was more spicy, more. You understand more all for the kinds, all these kinds we put inside in the.
Yeah.
When we're cooking, mm-hmm. It's better.
Ah, okay. So it had more flavour.
Yeah, yes. More flavour.
Well, Andrew, you know, I'm sure it does taste good. Does anyone want to try it? Anyone around here? No?
Yeah,
no. I don't think anyone wants to try it. No, I'm joking. But keep cooking, no, and I'm sure you'll perfect it sooner or later. But congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Right, a little token of our appreciation for being on the show. This is the recipe and the method of Sofrito.
Thank you.
So you can have it forever and keep it and cook it as much as you like.
Oh, brilliant.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And you can invite us around sometimes, we won't mind.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
We can go around and make
course,
a cook
of course,
for us.
Yeah, we can, yeah. Why not?
My yes. Pleasure.
Right, thank you very, very much. I want to thank our two contestants. You've been absolutely wonderful. You've made us laugh. You've cooked to the best of your ability, and you're both very interesting people. And thank you very, very much for coming to this show.
Oh, thank best you as well. Luck. Thank you, because you've restored my confidence in cooking, actually.
No problem. Thank you, Yaya, for that one.
Thank you. Yes.
You're welcome.
And our wonderful Yaya, thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Now that's it from us here on Yaya Show Me How to Cook. Here's until next time with some more mouth-watering Greek and Cypriot dishes. But for now, let's go with our closing message. Γεια σας και χαρά σας και να ακούτε τη γιαγιά σας
και την πεθερά σας.
Και την πεθερά σας και όλους. Thank you very much. If you would like to be part of our show and learn how to cook just like Yaya, please get in touch with Hellenic TV. Call us on 0208 292 7037 or you can email us on cook@hellenictv.net. For further details, check the Hellenic TV website or follow us on Facebook and Twitter.